Hello everyone, thank you for being here. This is new year 2021. The last year we showed you how our premium UHT milk brand Prospérité was perfect for barista applications. But today I'm going to present you the backstage of our brand and how it all happens at the very heart of our farms to get always the same high quality milk produced by our eco-friendly cows. Hope you'll enjoy. So as I said right before, I'm going to present you the behind the scenes of our premium UHT milk, Prospérité, that comes from an eco-responsible milk collection from our company, Ingredia. Before we go into the main topic of this webinar, I would like to give a quick introduction about the company and give you some key numbers for you to get us to know us better. So first of all, Ingredia, it's part of a dairy cooperative named Prospérité Fermière that has more than 70 years of experience in the business. It is located in the Hauts-de-France, more specifically, the headquarters are based in Arras, and the dairy plant that you can see at the right bottom of the screen, it's located at Saint-Paul-Tiers-Tournoise. So it's a company that has a structure that adds value to milk from the raw material to the dairy ingredient, also to the finished products. And it's, as its name implies, it's specialized in dairy ingredients. Also, another point that it's important to highlight is that we have a true savoir-faire or know-how that is made in France that's recognized by the region of the Hauts-de-France. Now, to give you some numbers about the company, you have to know that the cooperative Prospérité Fermière has around 1,200 farmers. With them, we are able to collect more than 420 milliliters of raw milk. At our dairy plant at Saint-Paul-Tiers-Tournoise, we have one bottling line that is capable of producing more than 60 milliliters of UHT milk. We have also five drying towers and three filtration lines that are able to produce more than 65,000 tons of dairy powders and proteins altogether. We have at the company around 450 employees, and in 2019 we made a turnover of 381 million euros, knowing that half of our turnover comes from the sales at the export. Now, in order to know why Ingredia is so important in the dairy sector and so innovative, it's because it has a strong strategy based on two pillars, because we believe that the development comes directly from our capacity to innovate and from our CSR policy called Via Lacta. Via Lacta, it's our CSR policy of the group, Prospérité Fermière Ingredia, based on three pillars. The first one is to research and cultivate the values of milk in accordance with nature. The second one is to guarantee the development of our partners. And the third one is to preserve the planet's ecosystem. So it is all based in one logo to guarantee our quality and our CSR commitments. So now, based on our sustainable approach, we created this eco-responsible milk collection called Milk from Grass-Fed Cows. And it's based on four pillars. The first one, animal welfare, then quality of milk, environment, and we have taken also into account the farmer's income. If we take a closer look on each one of these pillars, for the animal welfare one, we have strict specifications where we guarantee an access to pasture of 170 days per year per cow minimum, which means that the cows has to be outside for 170 days, but also has to be outside during 6 hours per day minimum. We also guarantee an accessible grazing area of 3,000 square meters minimum, which is divided in two areas, a pastured one and pastureable one. And this is not something that we guarantee because it may vary from farm to farm, but the average composition of pasture is ryegrass, white purple clover, fescue and veg. Yet at the barn we guarantee clean straw bedding because we want our cows to always be comfortable, and also it helps to prevent any injuries that they may get actually at the barn. And because we want to go even further on this animal welfare pillar, we have installed a behavioral diagnosis for animal welfare, where we do the assessment of the welfare of the cattle. We valorize our existing good practices at the farms. We promote awareness of the team of animal welfare around all of our farmers, and we identify areas of improvement. Concerning the quality of milk, what we mean by this is that in order to keep the quality of our, for example, premium UHT milk Prospérité, we guarantee the origin that it is 100% French. So our milk, it's locally collected at the Hauts-de-France only, at only 80 kilometers around our dairy plant, to guarantee a better quality. And you have to remember also that to keep this quality, our milk comes only from GMO-free grass-fed cows. So it is feed-certified GMO-free, and it is guaranteed by manufacturers certified also. And we have to feed all the cattle. That includes calves, heifers, cows in production, bulls. And during the winter period, we increase this ratio of grass in their diet. So we have to give them a diet with a ratio containing at least 15% of grass in dry matter. I want to go a little bit more in detail on this feeding of our cows, because it is not enough to emphasize that our cows are fed with only certified GMO-free feed for all cattle. So for calves, heifers, cows and bulls. But when we give them oil cakes or additives, they have to have a certified vlog or equivalent. If we give them co-products, they have to be origin France, if sensitive material, example, beet pulp or corn gluten. But it's the majority of it, it's self-production. So it is fodder, beets, corn that comes directly from the farms. But if we have to buy from suppliers, it's only coming from local suppliers. And the main component of the ratio I already have said it, but it is hay grass, corn, beet pulp, cereal grains, silage, rapeseed, seed, and or sunflower oil cake. And during the grazing period, during the winter, we have to give them a minimum of 15% of fodder in dry matter, excluding concentrates. That means excluding hay, grass silage, alfalfa, and wrapping. And all this to get the good amount of omega-3 and 6 intake via legumes, and to maintain a tasty quality. Now, moving on to our environmental specifications. So we do a lot of things in order to preserve our biodiversity, but the main ones are to preserve our local grazing area. We diversify the varieties in the meadows, like grass, legumes. We also increase the flowered areas and therefore the pollinization of them. We increase the soil structure through rooting, and we sow hedges for the parcel separation. And we try to reduce our carbon footprint by using manure as fertilizer. We also reduce the consumption of imported soybeans. We store carbon in permanent grasslands. And quite recently, actually, we have started a green milk collection. That means that our trucks run with 100% biofuel, and this means 60% less greenhouse gases. And to get involved in this eco-responsible program, our farmers have performed CAP-2R level 1 or 2 diagnosis. This is a tool for environmental assessment and technical support in ruminant farming. And last but not least, talking about the farmer's income, because their wealth is as important as everything else. So they have a fair, stable, and guaranteed price fixed for the year for each producer that is involved in this milk from grass-fed cows program. And there's also a recognition of their work. So there's a bonus per production of 15 euros per 1,000 liters. So this is for them to show them that their hard work is very valuable for us. With this, we have gone through all four pillars of this eco-responsible milk collection, but I think that it is not enough to see it as a PowerPoint presentation. So we wanted to show you how everything works in real life. So what we did was to take a camera with us in an eco-responsible farm and did an interview to a farmer for him to explain to us a day-to-day farmer's work. But first, I wanted to give you a quick overview on the average engaged farm that we have for this eco-responsible milk collection. So on average, the farms are family model ones of third generation, and for the moment we have 86 hired on this program. So the cattle that you will mainly find is prime Holstein cows, but you also could find Montbéliard cows or Normand ones. And on average, per farm, there are 44 cows. And an interesting fact is that each cow produces around 8,000 liters. And I already said it, but the main composition of grasslands is pasture, corn, wheat, and rapeseed. So now we will share with you the interview that we made at one of our farms that is part of our eco-responsible milk from grass-fed cows program.
Donc moi c'est Olivier Cuvier, je suis associé avec ma mère. Je me suis installé au 1er avril 2020, donc il n'y a pas longtemps. Et on cultive principalement du blé, du maïs, des betteraves, du lin, il y a des pâtures, il y a du riz gras, il y a de la luzerne. C'est assez diversifié et on a à peu près, actuellement mes parents ils avaient 60 vaches laitières et là je vais augmenter à 85 vaches laitières quoi, d'ici cette année quoi. Ce que j'aime c'est le contact avec les animaux. C'est pas un métier avec de la routine, donc il y a toujours un problème, il y a toujours une différence, tous les jours c'est différent. Je suis parti vraiment dans un aspect agroécologie, donc c'est-à-dire qu'on ne travaille plus du tout les terres et, pour redynamiser la vie du sol. Et si le sol va bien vivre, les plantes seront de meilleure qualité, donc les vaches vont produire de meilleure qualité. D'accord, donc bon, principalement il y a du maïs, après il y a du riz gras. Le riz gras est composé de 30% à peu près. Après je mets de la betterave, de la betterave fourragère. Ça permet de les faire saliver et nutritionnellement c'est super bon quoi. C'est très appétant, donc c'est pour ça qu'ils les recherchent en principal, principalement dans la ration. Et après je mets de la luzerne pour apporter de la protéine. Et de l'adresse de brasserie aussi pour la protéine. Et après du concentré quoi. Concentré pour ajuster la ration azote et protéines quoi. Donc la ration est distribuée une fois par jour, principalement au soir. Comme les vaches, ils restent plus au soir en étable, dans l'étable à vaches. Donc, et par contre, dans la journée, ils sont en pâture. L'été, plus au printemps, on va commencer à les sortir, tout dépend la pousse d'herbe, tout dépend la chaleur. Donc en général, ils sortent un petit peu quelques heures au partir du 15 mars. Et après, on va monter au niveau horaire, on va passer de 2 à 3 heures, on va passer après à 6, 8 heures par jour de pâturage jusqu'au 15 octobre, voire ça arrive début novembre. Et là, c'est pareil, arrivé en fin de saison, on va diminuer le jour de pâturage, le nombre d'heures de pâturage pour dire de complémenter à l'auge, quoi, parce que la valeur alimentaire n'est plus la même au niveau de l'herbe dehors. Quoi. Là, à partir de cet été, je vais partir en pâturage en dynamique. Donc, c'est-à-dire que je vais faire des paddocks. Je vais faire 26 paddocks dans mes parcelles sur 13 hectares. Donc, le but, c'est de valoriser au maximum le parcellaire, l'herbe. Donc, tous les jours, les vaches vont aller à une parcelle différente. Et le but, c'est de ne pas piétiner l'herbe pour automatiquement avoir des meilleures pousses et éviter le tassement, s'il y a un peu d'insectes, tout ça, éviter trop de piétinement, donc trop de dégradation au niveau de la prairie. Et après, sur l'exploitation, on a, depuis mes parents, depuis 15 ans, ils ont replanté à peu près 5 hectares de haies sur à peu près toute la surface de l'exploitation. Quoi. Moi, automatiquement, je mets des espèces qui fleurissent, donc il y a du sarrasin, il y a du tournesol, il y a du radis, il y a de la moutarde, c'est tout un ensemble. Quoi.
Hi again. Now, as a bonus of this webinar, we wanted to show you our last technological innovation that's still a world first for the dairy sector since 2019. So the milk produced by the cows of this eco-responsible milk collection is now fully traced and audited by blockchain. So this project started when we realized that consumers seek for more transparency in general, and they look for products in line with their values. 86% of consumers demand more for transparency, 89%, for example, leave a brand if they feel they have been fooled, and 75% of consumers will switch brands if another brand provided more detailed information about the product than what is indicated on the label. So based on these consumer expectations, we want to go even further towards total transparency, and we want to start with our UHT milk brand Prospérité. And with the promises that we stated on the label. And also knowing that we have a simplified list of ingredients and we already know the origin of the raw materials, Lille de France, we have the full traceability of the supply chain because the dairy sector is something that's very traceable. And the last thing that we needed to add for this was the digital audit in real time of our specifications, of our eco-responsible specifications for this milk collection. So what we did to get the digital audit of our eco-responsible specifications and also the full traceability in real time and available for our consumers was to digitize our sustainable approach by blockchain. And we did it with the help of Connecting Food, that it is a food transparency program for companies that wish to showcase the value of their products by lifting the veil on their product processes. For those who didn't know what the blockchain is, well, it is literally a chain of blocks. Its definition is that it is a shared ledger containing transactions which all parties are required to verify, and the information in it is linked together and cannot be modified. And what's the purpose of it? Well, it dispenses with intermediaries. It increases transparency, it shares information, and it renders immutable the information in it. It means that each party can see every transaction that it's made in the blockchain. It helps to share information between everyone, and the information cannot be erased. It can only be extended or modified, but everyone can see it. So you have to add another block to this chain. And the block is sealed. And finally, to explain how it works, well, we had to mobilize the entire dairy chain, which was quite challenging actually, because we needed information from the feed suppliers, the farms, the milk collection trucks, and also the bottling line at the dairy plant at some points or not. And because we wanted to go fully transparent with this, we wanted to have audited in real time the 100% Hauts-de-France origin, the guaranteed GMO-free feeding, the 170 days of cow grazing per year minimum, and also the minimum grazing area of 1500 square meters per cow. And then all this audit information and traceability information goes into the blockchain, and then it is printed as a dynamic QR code directly on the UHT milk bottles. And why dynamic? Because if you scan the QR code of this bottle today, you will not have the same information as if you scan another bottle in 2 weeks. So for example, if you scan this bottle today, you will have the farms where the milk was collected, the date when it was collected, and also the date when it was bottled. So all this information is available for consumers, and you have also the verification of the specifications audited in real time. So this is a true world first, and we're very proud to show it to you. So that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed this webinar as much as I did. We really wanted to show you how everything happens behind our premium brand Prospérité, because it's something that we are proud to share with you, the French quality that we take care of from the farm to the end consumer with, for example, just one product like our premium UHT milk. So it is an honor for us to be here today, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask them. I'll be staying here. I will just keep rolling this video a little bit to give you some images, quite nice images about our farms, and see you in a moment for the questions. Bye.